Every 98 seconds, someone is sexually assaulted in the United States. Chances are, it's happened to someone in your life, and you may not even know it. Well, it happened to one of our friends, an employee here at WHNT News 19. And that's why Lonnie Cleave says she needs to tell her story, to let sexual assault victims know they're not alone, and to help others be better equipped to protect themselves and their loved ones. WHNT News 19's Christine Killemeyer shares Lonnie's survivor story. And we do want to warn you, some may find this subject too graphic.
Time. It's said that it can heal all wounds, and it has a way of showing us what really matters. Lonnie Cleave spends her time as a wife, a mother, a daughter, a friend, and the digital sales manager for WHNT News 19.
So we'll start early Tuesday.
Now, she also spends her time as an advocate.
Then they should be super prepared, right?
Lonnie's new mission, driven by a simple 10-minute errand on July 28th of last year that morphed into a defining moment.
It was 11 a.m. on a Friday. We had clients that were in town. They had flown in. So whenever we have clients that are coming in, like to go get them something proper and Southern.
She parked in the Clinton Avenue garage in downtown Huntsville, rushed across the street to make a few purchases, and hustled back to her car before her meeting with those clients.
I had a humongous purse, I had a humongous bag, I had a very big umbrella, and I had very big heels. I walked across the street and decided to take the stairs. And as I was going up the stairwell, I saw someone, and my gut said, notice.
Lonnie continued to climb the stairs to the third floor and walked the 25 yards to her car.
I leaned in and I placed my bags, and as I began to turn, I was pinned against the car. In my mind, I have turned this into a 2-minute scenario just for the sake of knowing, having some time and space. When I turned, I immediately remember saying, please don't, and then I blacked out. In my 2-minute time frame, I'm guessing a good 30 seconds, I don't know what happened.
Lonnie says the man she saw in the stairwell, seen in this surveillance video just moments before the attack, masturbated on her and verbally harassed her.
In that time, he finished. And I was able, he had to step back, and I was able to make it out into where the cars would be driving by.
Would you consider that you were sexually assaulted?
It's an excellent question, and here's why. In my mind, sexual assault was being raped. If I was not thrown into the back of that car and raped, I was not sexually assaulted. Mm-hmm. You start listing off what is okay and what is not okay. Mine was a sexual assault. I was held. I was masturbated on. I was spoken to and told what was going to happen to me. I was sexually assaulted. There was so much shame in that moment.
Some kind strangers found Lonnie in this garage and helped her contact police. She later learned that security footage showed that man in this parking garage following women, some with young children. And in the months to come, police say different men attacked more women. But those that know Lonnie best would never believe she would be one of those victims.
I was chosen, I was put there, God was with me through it. I believe I was there because I was supposed to be able to handle it, and I didn't. Didn't make me wrong.
Ecclesiastes 3:7 says there is a time to be silent and a time to speak. For Lonnie Cleave, this was her moment to speak.
It did happen, and I would either own it, talk about it, do what I could to help me and help others, or I would never talk about it again.
So she shared her experience with her family, her friends, her coworkers, and her therapist. She signed up for self-defense classes, and she encourages others to do the same.
My definition of self-defense is completely different than what it was beforehand. Before, self-defense was a physical act that I can handle myself with someone. Now, self-defense to me starts well before an attack ever happens.
The Clinton Avenue parking garage is now equipped with more high-quality surveillance cameras.
And I came out.
And 9 months later, Lonnie returned to it.
When I say that I feel like I'm on holy ground, this actually does feel this way, because had it not happened, I wouldn't have met all the people and heard all the stories and had the connections that
that I have now, and I've never felt more loved or more taken care of, or that I have more of a purpose ever.
Lonnie no longer wears high heels when running errands. She uses a crossbody purse, utilizes store escort services, and unlocks only one car door at a time. She is more aware of her surroundings. She has helped organize self-defense classes for local churches, schools, and businesses, including here at WHNT News 19. And she empowers everyone to follow their instincts.
What I'm driven by is literally every person I see, I just want to grab them and say, trust your gut, trust your gut, trust your gut.
Time can heal all wounds, but it's what you do with that time that heals. In Huntsville, Christine Killemeyer, WHNT News 19.
More than 9 months later, Huntsville police still have not been able to catch the man Lonnie says assaulted her. So take a look at your screen. These are the surveillance video images of him. HPD is working with NASA to try to decipher the identity of this man. If you know who he is, investigators ask you to call their non-emergency line at 256-722-7100. Now, two other men are facing charges for similar crimes, but HPD says no other reports of this nature have been made in downtown parking garages since our coverage first aired last October. And if you are interested in learning more about self-defense, you can check out Grace Martial Arts. It offers self-defense classes for children, teenagers, women, men, families, senior citizens, churches, and more. Grace Martial Arts also plans to offer a clinic for parents and children at Cove Church and Owens Crossroads in the coming weeks. Now you can find more information in this story on WHNT.com or our news app. And if you've been the victim of sexual violence, you can call the National Sexual Assault Hotline 24/7 at 1-800-656-4673. Or you can contact Crisis Services of North Alabama. That number to call is 1-800-691-8426. Local service providers make it easy for you to access care, and they are so knowledgeable about local laws.